Hello, in today's Excel video, I'm going to teach you how to unpivot data using Power Query in Microsoft Excel. If you think this sounds really complex, it's not. I'm going to make this really simple. Let's go ahead and dive into unpivoting data. So I have a list of products over in column A, and I've got 12 months of the year running across row one. The issue is this. I should really only have three columns in this Excel spreadsheet. I should have a column for product. So column A is okay. I should have a column for months or dates. And then I should have a column for the values. So I really only need three columns, and here I am with 13. This data is sometimes called cross-tabular data. It is not how you want your Excel file set up most of the time. The issue is this, if I try to sort, filter, and run subtotals, I'm going to run into all kind of issues right now because I've got the 12 months going across the top. So instead of having to retype it, here we go with unpivot data. This needs to be in a table. I'm going to go ahead and make it a table first. So click inside your data and do Control T. My table has headers. That is correct. Click OK. So now I've got a table, and there's the table design tab at the top. That is a contextual tab. Now I'm going to go to the data tab, and here is get and transform data. I'm running Microsoft Excel 365. You should see this if you have 2016, 2019, 2022. One little item that's going to be slightly different. For me, it says from within sheet right here. Yours is probably going to say from table range. No big deal. Click it and this will open up Power Query. Power Query just opened up. There is my data running across the top here. This is really simple. Column A, as I discussed, is correct. It's the 12 other columns that are incorrect. By the way, I should end up with 36 rows because I've got 12 months of data and each row's got a numerical value in it. So 12 times 3 is 36. I'm just going to simply right click on product and there is unpivot other columns. I don't want to unpivot A. I want to unpivot the other columns. I'm going to go ahead and do this. Perfect. I have 36 rows of data. To back up or undo in Power Query is over here to the right where it says Applied Steps. I'm going to click that. The other option, instead of me right-clicking on A, would be to click on the first month, scroll over at the bottom, select the last month. Now I've got all 12 selected, right-click. So now it would be Unpivot Columns. I just want to show you both methods. Obviously, the first one was easier. I can rename these when I put them back into the Excel spreadsheet, but this is month. And what is the value here? I'm going to just call this something. There we go. Three columns, 36 rows, close and load to, close and load to. I want to put it into a table. Do you want to do it into a new sheet? Sure, here we go. Watch this. Right here. So now I can filter, sort, do subtotals, and I can make a pivot table. That is how you unpivot data in Microsoft Excel. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please let me know. Just so you know, coming up is one of my pet peeves. I'm going to do unpivot when people give me two header rows. I'll show you how to do that. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you.